Hello and welcome, my friend. And here is car doctor Peter Finn. And next, I am planning to show you that why this my car's horn is not working. And there is really a situation that electricity is on, and then when I press that my horn button in here, nothing happens. And then what is wrong in this my car's horn? And now I will go through all of these things what you need to check. And first and final step is that we go back in that steering wheel, because sometimes in inside of that steering wheel there is this switch what can be also broken, but let's go to look those easier areas next, because there is at least one. First part is that we have to check horn fuse. Second is that we have to check horn relay, and then we have to check horn by self, and then horn cables. And let's go to do those things. Okay, and first step what we need to check when we are looking in this horn issue, that we have to check that what is situation in our car's fuse and relay. And for that we have to go in engine bay area, and there is fuse box, and when I press these sides we can see this fuse box inside area. And then many cars, like in Honda cars and also in Mercedes-Benz cars, there is symbols in just in another side of this cover what tells that what is wrong in my car. And then we go to, then we look all of these symbols and we search horn symbol, and here is horn symbol in here, that one. And then also in here is horn. And this is great, because now we can think that one of these is relay and second is fuse. Okay, and let's go to look that area. And then idea is always that when we take that cover out, then we only carefully flap that in that position, and then we look that what map area is in here, is in here. Very easy. Like in that way, when we look that what is this 60 ampere fuse, it is in that one in here, this big yellow. And now I can take that away, this yellow, but it is a little bit stuck, and there is actually screws in here, and that it can be in there. But then we look that what is my horn relay, it is in that one, this part in here. And I need to only a little bit move that in this way and then pull out in that way. And this is horn relay. And now we can see that in my case, this relay in here. And sometimes this central area, this can be like broken, and then this fuse is bad. And we need to only purchase just same size, like in my 15 ampere fuse, and then we install this back. But this fuse is not a normal issue with horn things. More common is this relay, and then cables and horn, and then steering wheel button. And now when I install this my fuse back, I need to only press that in hard in this way, and they are in same plane in here. Okay, and this is this fuse box check, that we check fuse and also relay. And this is good to check if our horn is not working. And then we go to look this horn area. Okay, and then when I have removed this side area screws, this my pumper is ready for removal, and I carefully I move that in this way, and then I go in that direction, and I lift up that area in here, and carefully I put this my bumper away, and now we can see there is this bumper, and this another side looks like that, and now this part is ready for movement away. Excellent. Okay, and then we look this horn area, and this horn is normally in inside of this front bumper, and we have to take this front bumper away, or then we have to look in this down area that where is this horn positions, and then we need to take this horn's cable away, and sometimes we need to even cut in this horn's cable little bit far away in that area in here, that we can check that what is this horn's electricity status. And now I have already cut in that my second horn's cable, and I will reconnect these cables later. And in my car there is really two horns. In some cars is only one, and some cars are two or even more. And let's go to look this my first horn. Okay, and here is really this my first horn, and now I have take also, there is this my cable, there is this horn's cable, and in that my car there is that cable is plus cable, and minus cable is like body, and this horn takes contact in this body, and now I have connected this my horn cable in my light, testing light, and let's go to look my light next. Okay, and then we need to do some kind of testing light, and there is really this red cable, this come from this horn cable, and I have connected this my cable in that testing bulb, and then there is second, now I install this protective cover, because there is soon plus electricity maybe in here, and there is fresh bulb, and then in that area there is cable, black cable, what goes to this minus battery cable, and now I have connected that plus cable directly to minus LED in a car battery. And now there is idea that when I go to test this my car's this steering wheel's horn button, and if this cable works well, and also fuse and relay, then there should be light in this area in here. And let's go to test my this steering wheel next. Okay, and now I am really testing, pressing this my steering wheel in that way, all areas. And then we can maybe hear even some click sound, and it means that relay is working. And then we go to look this my testing bulb next. Okay, and now we'll look carefully that bulb. And next I will go to touch my this car's steering wheels this horn button, and if here is light, then I can say that at least four things works. First is that horn fuse is okay, second horn relay is okay, and third these cables are okay in my horn, and also this of course the steering wheel button is working. And next I go to press this my steering wheel, and let's check what happens. Yes. Now there is light, and that means now that now my issue is my horn, and let's go to
check then this my horn, because all other parts are now ready. And let's go to look my horn next. Okay, and here is really my horn. And now I have tested all components. And now only possible thing is that this my horn is really bad. Because I have now tested that my fuse works, my horn relay works, and also these cables works, and also steering wheel button works. And now final step is that I have to purchase new horn, and then everything works. And next I will also show you that how I open this my horn button, and I replace that horn. Okay, and this job starts so that there is this 12 millimeter bolt, and I need to open this this bolt, and I can use this electric drill driver or then wrench, and this bolt opens easily, and there is this bolt, and now this horn is free. And then I need to take this connector away, and I press that away in that way, and now connector is free. And then I need to only purchase new horn, and then this my fix is ready. Okay, and now I have in here new horn. This is like pre-used from California, some used Honda Civic car, and let's check now that how this my horn works now when I press steering wheel button. Okay, excellent. And now this my repair is ready, my friend. Thumbs up, and remember how to check and repair my bad horn. There were those five areas. First is fuse, second relay, third these cables, and fourth is this horn, and fifth is steering wheel. And let's go to look also steering wheel next. Okay, and then really final part is that if we have any horn issues, we have to replace the central part. And there is two fuse in, screws in this back area. And I will also do later video that how to take that out, because there is also this airbag in inside the central area. But this is easy to test if everything, those fifth another things are okay. And then when I press that, and if horn works, but if not, then I have to replace the central part. And I can also purchase these parts in used parts, pre-owned, from these Californian and US recycle car recycle centers, like eBay and internet. And then, my friends, thumbs up, and see you in next movie.